Welcome to our new video. Today we're gonna show you how to set up a PayFast button which can collect money each and every month, which they call a recurring collection, or that could sound as a debit order collection for each and every month. You can collect it each and every year, and after 6 months, or after every month end. So it's all gonna be up to you. So but the thing is, you don't want the stress of telling people pay me or whatever, or calling them or emailing them for payments. You want the money to be debited each and every month, every after 30 days, every after month, every after 6 months, every after a year, every after whatever you're gonna choose. I'm gonna show you the options they have, and you're gonna do this with this without even using a plugin. So the process is very, very simple. What you do, log into your PayFast, then you click on generate pay now button or request payment. So if I click generate, what do we see? These are the options we have. Okay, and if I click on request payments, what do I see? This is the options I have. This one, they say this one you can put in how much whatever, then you create this, and that's gonna work like what they call a donation, or someone who will pay you with, if in case you don't have a website, this is something whereby somebody's gonna, it's gonna email him. When he clicks on that email, then he's gonna be able to pay you. Even if you don't have a website, you can collect money from your people. So you just have to send this only, then you send it to you put the person's email, you put your amount, you collect goods, services, whatever you do, donation, subscription, anything you want. Okay, that's all about that. We didn't come in here for that, but that's the second button. If you see it, that's what it does. So the second thing is here, the first thing, like pay now buttons, that's when you're gonna say generate. After clicking generate, you're gonna see all these buttons. You can if you click dark, you can see the button change. If you click large, you get a very big button here. If you click small, you get it small. If you click it small, large, you can small, light, whatever you want, that's what you get. So the default settings are like this. So now here we have pay now, buy now, donate now, subscribe now, link button, email link, button with HTML form. So what do we need here? We need to do like something like a monthly subscription. You click here. After clicking there, then you say which services are you giving to the people, and then you put that. So maybe the services are what we say, maybe online tutorials, online programming. Okay, so tutorials. Okay, after doing that, what's gonna happen here, you can put a description here, but if you don't have, you can leave it. So after doing that, you can go down here and say put how much you wanna put. Maybe I put 100. Okay, depends on your country, then it's gonna be, if you're in the US, 100 US dollars. If you're in South Africa, it's gonna be 100 rands. If you're in India, 100 rupees. If you're in whatever country you are, it's gonna be that money, that country's money. So now, if maybe you registered this account in a different country, and you're in a different country, when you log in, it's gonna give you the money of that country where you registered this from. Okay, right. So here they ask that recurring amount, if you wanna put recurring amount, maybe now someone, when he comes in here, is gonna click here, it's gonna do what? It's gonna, maybe you have what they call maybe registration fee or opening fees, whatever. So whenever somebody, when somebody clicks on the button, this is the money is gonna pay. But if you want recurring amount to be different, you can put here if it's 100 or 200, no, if 200. But if it's not different, What PayFast is gonna do is gonna take the same money here. So this money can represent this if you don't put nothing here. So, but if this is less, the recurring money is less or more, then you can put here. But it's not necessary if it's the same as the money when which gonna be collected when somebody clicks that button. So that's good. So they say subscription cycle. You can see that you can see what it says. Say the number of payments for the subscription, if set to zero, the subscription will run until it's cancelled. So for instance, you want to collect maybe for 1 year. If 1 year, you can put 12 here, like 12. If it's forever, until somebody cancels, like, you know, when you are in a gym, there's no canceling. So whenever you want to go, you go gym. If you don't want, then this month you didn't go. As long as you don't cancel, they're gonna still take your money. Understand? So this is gonna happen like that. If this person does not cancel this, and you put infinite, whatever you call it, if you click here, it will put zero automatically. So that simply means it's gonna be forever until the person cancels that. So you have to be aware, and your clients, you must tell them that I don't know what you how you collect your money, but if you collecting for only six months, I'm not saying for 6 months, but for only 6 months, every month until June, or until from June to December, then you can put six. If you're collecting for five, maybe five. If you're collecting forever, the service is gonna continue until the person say, I'm no more into this. Okay, right? That's okay. Subscription currency, frequency. You can see monthly, quarterly, bio, annual, and also annually, biannually. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Can select for 6 months, 1 month, a year, whatever. So whatever you want on these options that will select, you can select monthly to be selecting each and every month. Then here, you want the URL return is the page on where site users are returned after successful what payments includes HTTP. So now here it's you can leave these as long as you don't have those websites to do that, or a link or a page. So but if you have a page, you can put a page, any page you want to put. I can put that page, and here also I can put that page. So that simply means if somebody cancels, it's gonna go here. So maybe you can create a page which says, if somebody cancels that, you know what, maybe we're gonna miss you, whatever, all this, and in whenever, anytime you want to come back, please, you are free to come back, you understand, things like that. You can do that. This one, if somebody proceeds and pay after payments, PayFast is gonna bring him to this page. This page, maybe you can put maybe, or if somebody has to download something, then after payments, then it's gonna go on that page, and that page is gonna what, download for him or her something, or give him or her a link to download that. After that, you're gonna click on generate button. So when you generate that button, you're gonna copy that button straight, and what you do, you copy it and you're gonna put it in your website or on any page you want to put it. So now I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna go to one of the website put it there. Okay, then when I log in, it's give me some stress. I'm trying something here. I guess that works for me, and if it works, yes, it worked. So I want to put it somewhere. I'm gonna go on some of the I'm gonna go to widgets. I want to put it somewhere on each and every page. It's gonna be just a test, which I'm going even to delete. Okay, put it on, you can select something like HTML custom HTML, then you drag it here on the sidebar. If you want to create a page, you can create a page for that. After that, you can then put this here. So this is what I did put in here. So I can copy that, and I'm gonna delete whatever is here. Then I select and put that HTML code. So okay, I'm gonna paste here. I've pasted this. After pasting that, I'm gonna save. After saving that, I'm gonna say done. Okay, after done, then I'm gonna go and say googleboy.co.za. Then we scroll down, and we want to see that button. If we see it, then we're gonna click it, click on it. You see it says subscribe monthly, you can see. Then you click here, and once you click there, you cancel here. Let me see, you see I've clicked that. So you see it takes you to PayFast already. So when it takes you your client to PayFast, simply means it doesn't have, is no more on your website. That's why they put that after payments, where is he gonna go? So when the person also can see that future recurring amount is 100 rands. So this simply means that the person, now you're making them aware that they are paying for online programming tutorials, and also they are going to be billed each and every month, which is future recurring amount, which is 100 rand. And say due now, which is the money they owe you now. They, if they pay, that's the money they're gonna be billed now. So this form, it's clear to a person that what is he paying for, and is gonna be also debited each and every month. Okay, enter credit card or check details. So the client is gonna enter everything here. So once it does payment, the money is gonna come to your PayFast account, and also that it's gonna take him to the page or a URL you set in to be to go on. Okay guys, I think that's it, and I believe that helps. And please don't forget to subscribe. If there's something I didn't explain well, I would like you guys to forgive me. And also, if you have something to ask, you can ask me now, so that we answer your question. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, and see you in the next video.